This is the Mizuno Wave Rebellion. It features Mizuno's most advanced midsole foam technology, but it also still has a wave plate. Can Mizuno revive its brand with this melding of the old and the new? Or is this a shoe that is trying to be too many things for too many people? It's time to lace up the Wave Rebellion and take it for a run. miles, 8 minutes, 40 seconds per mile, and 141 beats per minute today, taking the Mizuno Wave Rebellion out for a first run. And let me tell you, this shoe definitely surprised me. Now, before I give you my thoughts on this shoe, though, I do want to go over some disclosures. This is a pair of shoes that was sent to me by Mizuno and Running Warehouse for the purpose of review. However, no one is paying me to make this video or to use the shoe, and nobody's gonna get a chance to preview any of my footage or my thoughts before you guys get a chance to see this video on YouTube. So with that disclosure out of the way, let's talk about the brand new Mizuno Wave Rebellion. First, let's go over some specs. This $180 shoe has a 38 millimeter stack height with an 8 millimeter drop, giving us 30 millimeters of stack height in the forefoot. And that midsole is comprised of two things. We've got Mizuno's latest midsole foam technology with Mizuno Enerzy Enerzy Lite, L-I-T-E foam, which is a new iteration of the Mizuno Enerzy foam that they introduced last year. This year's version is lighter and is supposed to provide more responsiveness. There's also still a wave plate in here, and that wave plate is a pretty big one. It is a glass fiber reinforced plastic plate, which I'm not sure if that means it's fiberglass or if that means something different. And it's designed to do two things in this shoe. One, it's to provide stability, so that way this foam doesn't come crashing down in any direction. And two, it's supposed to be a little bit propulsive, just like a carbon fiber plate would, but just kind of on a reduced extent because it's a different material. On the outsole, there is a brand new material that I don't think I've ever seen used before. It's called PU resin. I don't know if that stands for polyurethane resin, but it's PU resin. It's not rubber as far as I can tell. It looks like rubber, but it seems to be a lot stiffer and a little bit more dense than rubber is. And they've got it all throughout the outsole here in these lug patterns, which is something that we've seen in some other shoes before. I always tend to love kind of like the studded outsole look. But there is a lot of this stuff on the outsole here. And then I think underneath it, it looks like there's like fabric or something underneath that in between like this outsole layer and the midsole foam that it's protecting. Also, you can see in this little window down here, that plastic wave plate. Moving to the upper, there is an engineered mesh that is very comfortable, very breathable, a nice stretchy material that leads back towards the midfoot cage, and a tongue that I absolutely love in terms of material. It's very, very thin. It's like a thin piece of stretchy fabric. It's just kind of like a gusseted piece of fabric that's on there. And there's a little bit of a plastic overlay on the top of the tongue, which features the name of the shoe. Moving around back to the heel cup, that's where I feel like this is like the most familiar like Mizuno-ness of it, other than like the wave plate itself. That's also a very signature Mizuno thing. But if you've run in any Mizuno shoes, you're gonna be very familiar with the heel cup that I got back here. There's a lot of structure. There's not a lot of give in this heel cup area back here. And there's a decent amount of padding all along the heel collar. It's not quite as thickly padded as say like a max cushion shoe, but for daily trainers, this is more than kind of like typically see. It's very comfortable to be in here, but it also kind of curls up over the back of the heel and keeps everything really nice and snug. Overall, I think the shoe comes in at a pretty lightweight 8.8 ounces or 294 grams. Now let's talk about what it was like to run in this shoe. But I think first I got to talk about an experience that I had that was very interesting in terms of my first kind of day with this shoe. So I put the shoe on to take the kids to school. We walk to school, I drop off both of the kids, then I usually come home, finish up my YouTube video for the day, and then I go for my run. I normally don't like walk in shoes that I'm gonna run in for the first time. I usually only run in my running shoes, but I thought I would give this a shot because I wasn't sure about this shoe. It looked like a kind of like a lot of things going on in this shoe, and I had some concerns about it. So I thought, you know, let's give it a walk, see how we feel. And my fears were like all realized in the walk. So I felt a lot of weirdness. It felt like a very, very tall shoe. I didn't know what the heel drop was on this shoe before I put it on, and I was thinking it was gonna be either a 10 or a 12 millimeter drop. And it felt about that, maybe even a little bit taller. Mizuno shoes always just feel like you're just like really kicked up far high up in the back of the heel and like kind of ramming down towards the front. But in addition to that, I felt like there was a lot of like extra foam right here in this part of like the medial side of the heel. And so it kind of felt like the shoe was like kind of tilted out this way. And there's a very aggressive rocker on this shoe. So you could see kind of like the way it's sculpted. There's like foam, and then whoosh, it shoots up really quick. The idea with that is that as your foot is hitting, it's gonna roll through really quickly and easily. So it picks up that back part of the heel and gets you into your next stride very quickly. But it is pretty aggressive. And as I was walking, it didn't feel like it was very even. It felt like as I was getting to like this point in my step, the shoe is kind of kicking out that way, combined with like the extra material that seemed to be over on this side of the shoe. I always just felt like the shoe was kind of like crooked and sideways. So walking in the shoe was really uncomfortable. I had a 10 mile run planned for the day, and I was like, I don't know if I want to take this shoe for 10 miles. But I thought, you know what? Let's see how far we can get. I've been running in Mizuno shoes for a long time. The first marathon I ever ran back in 2010. I've trained in Mizunos. I raced in Mizunos. So like I go back with Mizuno shoes. I've been enjoying them for a long time. Although lately I feel like they haven't really made the advances that I was hoping that they would make. So I thought I'd give this one a little bit more of a shot. And I was really pleasantly surprised once I started getting out there running. What I found is that I wasn't really using this part of the shoe at all. So this part that concerned me, I wasn't really hitting it as I was running. I'm more of a midfoot striker, and I felt like I was landing right here. And I was worried that that part where it kind of seems like it kind of tilts to the side would be annoying while running. I didn't feel it at all. So I think that whatever weirdness is happening with the shoe while you're just walking around, let's say you're trying it on at the store and giving it a shot, make sure you're getting on the treadmill and taking it for a run, or see if they'll let you run around the block with the shoe, just so you can get a chance to run in it how you would normally run in it. Because this section, like this section of the shoe right here, really, really nice. And so the foam, it kind of looks like Power Run PB foam that you've seen in the Endorphin Speed or in the Endorphin Pro. And I think that it kind of responds that way too. But it's a little bit different. I feel like there's a little bit more of a controlled squish to it. So when I think about foams, there's a couple of ways that I think about foams. One is that they could be really bouncy. Like think about like hitting a racquetball against a very hard wall. It's gonna ping right off the wall and bounce really quickly. And there's other foams that are really squishy. And if they're really squishy, hopefully they're also really like unsquishy too. So in terms of the compression, decompression, hopefully that happens fast and there's a lot of travel. This shoe was really neither pingy like a racquetball or squishy kind of like memory foam. It was somewhere kind of in the middle and also not at the same time. Because here's the thing that was very different about it. It seems like it was squishy, but in a very controlled way. So it wasn't like bouncing. It was kind of like hitting the ground, compressing a little bit, and then decompressing in a very controlled way as well. And so I felt it was like almost like a hydraulic type of feeling when I was running in this in an unusual way, but in a way that also was really working for me. So I found myself really enjoying my run out there today. I was running for the most part at very easy paces, running along the lakefront, and I just felt like this was a shoe that I could just go in. Then towards the end of the run, around mile 8, or I think around right around mile 8, I threw in a couple of strides to see how it'd do at some faster speeds. Because when I read the copy for this from either the Mizuno website or from the Running Warehouse website, the language is all kind of positioning this as kind of like your workout shoe, your fast day shoe, maybe your race day shoe, but something that also can handle a little bit more mileage as well. So I hit the strides, and it was, again, another weird sensation. It was a shoe that kind of took a little bit to get up to speed. The shoe definitely feels like a little bit bottom heavy to me, so like it definitely is a little bit awkward when you're going from one speed to another. But once I got to that other speed, I felt like I was able to kind of just get there and cruise at that speed. And then I just also felt like the turnover wasn't quite as snappy. Now that just could be me. I'm pretty deep into peak week for my marathon training, so the legs are definitely taking a bit of a beating, but I still nevertheless felt like I didn't really get the fastest of turnover in this shoe, but I still overall felt like I was getting to the paces that I needed to get to really well, and that kind of like controlled compression, I still felt like I was getting a lot of that with this shoe rather than a squish and decompress or a bounce. I felt like I was still getting that behavior of this Mizuno Enerzy Lite foam even at my more intense efforts when I was putting more force into the shoe. So that was really good to see as well. So I do think that it is something that can be used for like your fartlek workouts, your threshold workouts, certainly can fit into that kind of speed day, your workout day shoe. But I also feel like there are some durability elements to this shoe that also in a good way and in a bad way, make it fit as kind of a daily trainer as well. So let's talk about some of the fit. I thought the upper fit very much like a Mizuno shoe. It reminded me of the Wave Rider in terms of the way that it fits in terms of width and length. Everything fit very kind of like good. Nothing felt like great, fantastic, but everything felt really good. I do like this tongue a lot. I especially like the fact that there's no padding on it whatsoever, and they resisted the urge to try to like make it more comfortable with a bunch of like foam in there, but instead it's just like this really thin, stretchy piece of material. I really enjoy that. The only thing is like this tongue kind of like sticks out a lot. It's like a little bit too tall for me, and I just felt like it was a little bit awkward. So I didn't like that. I'm guessing some people probably will like it because I usually like the tongues that everyone else complains that are too small. Those are the kinds of tongues that I like. This one is like the opposite of that. It's super long. And then back here, there's kind of like a lot of padding and there's a lot of structure in the heel cup, which I also don't really love that so much either, but I feel like this is kind of like a very signature Mizuno kind of feel to it. So if you've been running in Mizunos and are very comfortable with the heel fit and that lockdown, you're gonna like the way that this one fits as well. Moving to the outsole though, this is where I feel like there's a lot of great stuff happening here, but I also feel like there's just a lot of stuff that's happening here too. So with this PU resin, it seems like it is, like I mentioned before, making the shoe really bottom heavy. And while I do love kind of like the look of this like studded outsole pattern, I just wish there wasn't so much of it. And I know there's like a big cutout here for that window into the wave plate. And you know, it's not like it's a full rubber outsole that's on here, but I feel like this still just feels like a lot. And I don't know that it's really necessary for what this shoe is supposed to be. And I feel like the amount of outsole that's in here is more of a concession to durability than it is to performance. And I feel like for a shoe that they're positioning at $180 that you're supposed to use for your faster workouts and even for your races, like I think that they're paying a little bit too much heed to that objective of durability and not really letting this Mizuno Enerzy Lite really, really shine. The other thing that I would have loved to have seen, even if just as some sort of experiment, is to see what would this shoe be like with either no wave plate or a much reduced wave plate, because I do think that they've really got something interesting on their hands here with this Mizuno Enerzy Lite, and I'd like to see that come through a little bit more forward in the shoe. But overall, I feel like I'm very happy and very surprised with this Mizuno Wave Rebellion. I didn't think that I was gonna like this shoe at all, but it turns out that I'm very much liking it. I definitely am very excited about where Mizuno is going with this Wave Rebellion, and I hope that this means there's a lot more exciting new product coming from Mizuno. I know that they have like die-hard, faithful people that love everything that they've been doing for a long time, and that's great. That's just not me, though, at least not anymore. It was in 2010, but it's not me in 2021, and so I'm really excited about what this Wave Rebellion could mean for what's coming in the future. But for now, I will have to say though, at $180, I feel like this is a tough shoe for me to recommend. I don't know, you know, I haven't been really following the prices of Mizuno shoes throughout like the course of a year that closely lately. So I don't know how much Mizuno shoes go on sale, but I just feel like this $180 price point doesn't quite feel right. I'm not sure it's quite delivering at that $180 price point. I at $160 or like $150, I'd be recommending for a lot of people to go and try this shoe. If you've tried and enjoyed Mizuno in the past but have stayed away for a little while, this could be a really great way to get back into it. So keep an eye out on it if this is something that's interesting you. At $180, I don't think it's a bad buy, but I would love to see it a little bit cheaper. So hopefully it will go on sale and maybe we could find it at that sweet spot price, which I think is the amount of performance that this shoe is delivering. So those are my thoughts after just this first day with the Mizuno Wave Rebellion. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions, or better yet, feel free to stop by the live stream that I do Monday through Friday right here on YouTube, and I'd love to be able to talk to you guys in the chat. That's all I have for today, everybody. Thanks so much for making it all the way to the end of the video. Hopefully you guys are staying safe out there on your runs, and I'll see you in the next one.
Yo, what's going on?